Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to deploy our sample ASP.NET application on IIS web server with Octopus Deploy Server. In previous video we built and copied the artifact of our sample application on Octopus Deploy Server from Team City. This is artifact of our application and we are going to deploy it on IIS web server. So let's begin. First of all, we require to create a infrastructure or environment for this project. So click on infrastructure, then add environments. Give the name of environment. Give the description if you want. Default guided failure mode. Enable it. It means that if this particular environment encounter any problem, it is going to prompt or asking a action from the user to fix the problem. It is highly recommended to enable it on the non-production environment because you always want to fix the problem as soon as before going to production. Leave the dynamic infrastructure. We are going to use static infrastructure. Go ahead and save it. Now you require to add IIS machine or server for this environment to deploy your application. So click on add deployment target. You can choose any flavor of the target machine. Since IIS is hosted on my Windows machine, so I am selecting Windows. You can use any of the communication way for your target machine. Listening tentacle. It is push method. Octopus server will send notification or configuration changes to the target machine whenever it is required. It is highly recommended method because it consumes less resource on your machine. Second is pulling method. In this method, the target machine will periodically calling to the Octopus server to check any task for him. You can connect your Azure VM by using this method. So I am using the listening method. We require to install Tentacle agent on target machine to establish a communication between Octopus deploy server and target machine. So I am downloading the agent 64-bit version. This is my IIS machine and I am going to install the agent on it. This is the agent which we downloaded. Okay, it has been installed. Now we require to configure it. Again, it is giving the option push and pulling. We are good with push method. We are okay with the default directory. Now you require thumbprint or certificate of your Octopus deploy server. So this is thumbprint of your Octopus deploy server. Copy it and paste here. Next, go ahead and install. It has been done. Let's go ahead and finish it. Now you can see here agent is running. Let's configure this machine in Octopus server. Give the hostname or IP address of your target machine. Leave the default port. Leave the default proxy setting. Go ahead and click on next. Give the display name environments. You can select more than one environment. Since we have only one development environment, so it is selected by default. Select the target role. At this moment we don't have any target role. Target role is like a tag, so I'm creating a new target role or tag for this deployment. Add new role. select the policy. So I'm okay with default machine policy, leave default communication settings, go ahead and save it. Now check the connectivity. Let's perform health check on this machine. Okay, it's completed with some warning. It is saying that Calamari version is outdated. Don't worry, it is going to up to date automatically when we are running our first job on the target machine. Who doesn't know the role of Calamari? Let me tell you. Basically, Calamari take the instruction from Tentacle Agent and perform all the activity on the target machine. So health check completed on the machine. At this moment, no deployment on this machine. You can check events on the target machine. For example, deployment target became healthy but has some warning. You can see more information about the particular events. So now time is to create the project. So click on projects and create project. Give the project name. Next process. In the process, add steps for your activity. So click on steps. You can select the template for your activity. For example, we are going to deploy application on IIS web server. So search a template for the IIS machine. It found one installed template and 44 community templates. Let's use the default IIS template. Okay, give the step name you want to enable or disable. I will go with default. Execute location. By default, Octopus execute steps on the target machine. Select the target roles. So we are going to perform this activity on web roles. Now we require to select the package or artifacts. So get the package ID. So let me open the Octopus interface on another tab, and this is our package ID which we want to deploy. Now we require to configure the IIS web server. Do you want to create a IIS website? I will go with this option. Give the website name. Now you require to select a location or path of the website where artifact is going to be deployed. You can go with the default location or custom location. So I will go with the custom installation directory. For this, click on configure features and click on custom installation directory. Okay, now you can see one more features has been added here. So I want to deploy the package or artifact of this application on that location. Now come back to our website. We are good. After deployment, start the website. Create a new application pool of this website. Select the ASP.NET framework version. This application using .NET framework 4.7.1. So I will go with the version 4.0. Leave the default application pool identity and start the application pool after deployment. You can add binding or virtual host entry. I am going to leave it a default one. You can enable or disable IIS authentication. For this demonstration, I am going to use enable anonymous authentication and disable Windows authentication. I am not going to use any variable at this point. It is very useful when you are deploying same artifact or package on multiple location, but you require to modify or change the connection string according to the environment. For example, for the development machine, the connection string of the database will point to development database in the web.config file. For the production environment, it is going to point your production database in the web.config file. We are going to use this option in coming video, but for now leave it default and leave other setting as a default. Go ahead and save it. Next, go for variables. At this point we are not going to use variables. Let's look at triggers. We are not going to use triggers or automatic release at this moment. Next one, channels. We are going to use a default lifecycle. You can create custom lifecycle of the application. We will discuss about this in coming video. And go for release. Create a release for your environment. Give the version name of the release. I am okay with default one. Select the package which you want to use in this release. At this moment we have only one release and it is latest one. If you have multiple artifact or release, you can select which release or artifact you want to use for this deployment. Add release note if you want. Go ahead and save it. So we are ready to deploy this artifact or package on the target machine. Let me show you the target machine. So we don't have any website apart from default website, no custom application pool. So let's go ahead and deploy to development environment and click on deploy. The process has been started. So it looks like deployment has been completed. Let's look at the task log. Deployment completed successfully. Acquired package, upload package, deployment on server, and apply the retention policy. Let's verify on IIS web server. Okay, now you can see one more website has been created, ESOP, and one more application pool has been created, ESOP, and package or artifact has been uploaded on our desired location. Let's try to access the application now. Yes, I can access the application on the browser. I can access the database in the backend. Everything looks clean and great. Brilliant. So this is the complete step how to deploy ASP.NET sample application on IIS web server with Octopus Deploy Server. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.